The word Acropolis means the highest point in a city. Perhaps the most famous Acropolis is the 500-foot-high rocky outcrop that towers above the city of Athens, Greece. Many buildings sit atop the Athenian Acropolis, but the word Acropolis refers only to the hill itself. The Acropolis at Athens has been occupied for more than 5,000 years, and we know that since at least 1,500 years before the Common Era, the Greeks held festivals there to honor the goddess Athena, goddess of wisdom and cities, and protectress of Athens. Many of the temples on the Acropolis were shrines to Athena. The Persians destroyed the city of Athens and its temples in the 6th century before the Common Era, and after the Greeks defeated the Persians, they began a great rebuilding effort called the Classical Period, which produced new temples. Greek temples represent three basic architectural orders. The characteristics of these orders are most readily identified by columns and capitals. The first, the oldest and simplest, is the Doric order. Its columns have no base and a very simple slab for a capital. That is, the transition from the shaft of the column to the architrave that supports the roof. The second order is the Ionic. Its column capitals exhibit ornamental scrolls. The third and most recent architectural order, the Corinthian, has a base on which the column rests and an ornate capital depicting acanthus leaves. Climbing to the top of the Acropolis at Athens, we see, to the right of the entrance, the Temple of Athena Nike. In Greek, the word Nike means victory. The four columns across the front of the building indicate that the Temple of Athena Nike is Ionic. The actual entrance to the top of the Acropolis is called the Propylaea. In ancient times, the Propylaea had beds placed in its corridor, so visitors could rest and refresh themselves before they entered. Another part of the Propylaea was a portrait gallery hung with paintings of famous Athenians. Emerging from the Propylaea, we come face to face with a majestic Parthenon, a large temple built to honor, and in which stood a 50-foot-tall statue of, the goddess Athena. Like all Greek temples, the Parthenon adheres to very strict standards of balance and harmony. The front and rear of the Parthenon each have one row of 8 columns. The sides each have a row of 17 columns. The corner columns are counted both times. One of the characteristics of the columns of the Parthenon is the slight swelling at the middle of each column. This swelling is called entasis, and occurs in order to compensate for the optical illusion that columns with perfectly straight parallel shafts appear to curve inward at the middle. Correcting this tendency restored the balance and harmony that was critical to the design of classical architecture.